What's up, everybody? I'm Matrix, and today we're going to continue our playthrough of Elden Ring New Game Plus. And this time, I don't think we're going to go to Stormveil Castle. I think we're going to wander around the Weeping Peninsula and check out some of Limgrave and see where we go from there. So I'll show my stats, and then we'll get started. Alright, now we can get moving. There is a church up in here where you can get a sacred tear, but I'm not going to stop for that because I'm probably not going to find it because there's so much forest in the way. Although honestly, it should be on my map. There it is. This is going to take me back out to where I started from. I don't remember exactly where to go, but there are a couple of churches here in the Weeping Peninsula that I want to find and light up the graces. I just gotta find the spot where I can drop down. Thank you. and we'll see what we can find over here. This is actually what I was looking for, this bridge. And you can see that church up in the distance there. That's one of the churches that I was gonna head towards. See that statue there with the sacred tear in front of it. My flasks are already at plus 12, so I'm not gonna pick it up. Alright, now we'll go looking for the other church. See that walking bell over there, and you can see the church in the distance, so we'll head there next. Church, so you can get powered up pretty fast. Alright, now we're gonna warp back to Limgrave and just wander around there for a little while. Kenneth Height, and then I'm gonna go to Fort Height and kill all the enemies that are in there so I can progress somebody's quest line.
Right this way. Right this way. Welcome, valued castles. I'm hung.
I don't remember exactly where Kenneth is, so I'm going straight to Fort Height and I'll clear out the enemies there first. Demi-humans attacking the fort, and then you've got regular soldiers, but the soldiers are the real threat. That's the main guy that we have to kill for Kenneth, so we need to go get him. And Bloody Slash is what I always equip on my Antspur Rapier so I can get blood and rot. Dectus Medallion is something that you need to take you up to Altus Plateau, so you have to come here regardless, unless you want to take a more difficult route to get up there. Now we'll see if we can go find Kenneth. This will take you to the Siofra River, so I'm going to go in here and light up the Grace, and then I'll come back up top and look for Kenneth. Alright, so I was wandering around looking for Kenneth, and I finally found him, so I cut that part of the video out. Here he is, on this part of the map right here. Since we've already killed the knight inside Fort Height, he wants us to go back there and enter his service, and he can ascend us to knighthood. So I'm going to warp back down to Fort Height and kill the demi-humans that are inside, and then we'll talk with him again and progress the quest line that we're progressing. Kenneth is lamenting the sorry state of his fort, says that he can't ascend us to knighthood, and he needs to find a lord to rule Limgrave, so we'll progress that quest line and get help from an NPC for doing it, which is very useful. But in the meantime, we're going to head out elsewhere and check out some more stuff. Alright, this is Siofra River, and I think we're going to light up the bonfires here on the torch sconces, and we'll fight one of the Remembrance bosses down here, so we'll see how fast we can get through it. The other things that I like about Elden Ring, in addition to your stamina bar being so long and low endurance, is that your endurance, your stamina, comes back pretty fast even without the talisman. It speeds it up, which was a problem I had with the Souls games. I don't remember where all of the sconces are, so we're gonna have to look around until we find them, but when we do, we'll be able to fight a boss from it. you kill enemy groups, you get your healing flasks back. Which is what that red mist that I got was. Sconces that we have to light before we can fight the Remembrance boss, so I'm gonna have to keep looking around for them. And like I said in my last video, you can sprint as long as enemies are not following you, which is why I wasn't losing any stamina while I was running. And we gotta be careful about those lightning balls in the water, because they will deal a lot of damage, if not outright kill you. one thing worth noting about those lightning balls is that if they shoot their lightning balls or their lightning attacks at you, they will expend themselves and they'll die from it. So you can just hide from them for a minute and then they should disappear. Up there is an elevator that takes you into Caelid, where you can fight the Great Jar's duelists and get the Great Jar talisman to carry more equipment without being over encumbered. Got all the sconces lit. If I remember right, the boss is up here up these stairs. This will be our first Remembrance boss, and I'll call the video after this. I mean, if you play your mimic ashes right, you can get them to kill bosses pretty quickly, especially since I use my mimic ashes as artillery instead of straight up fighting. I usually draw attention with my sword and let my mimic throw fireballs at whatever boss I'm fighting, and it works out very well for me, as you can see what just happened. But anyway, I'm gonna call the video here, so I hope everybody enjoyed watching, and I'll see everybody again next time. Take care.